Welcome to Zearn. In this video, we'll show school leaders how to use data from their admin reports to support their teachers and students as they implement Zearn Math. You can think about your Zearn implementation as a gradual progression through these stages. First, are teachers and students signing in regularly? Next, are students learning with Zearn for at least 90 minutes a week? And finally, are students completing at least 3 lessons a week? You'll find the data for each of these stages in the School Goals Report. To get to the School Goals Report, go to the Reports tab. Under Admin Reports, click on School Goals. The School Goals Report is designed to let you evaluate school-wide progress and productivity. The report shows a summary of each grade at the top. You can toggle between seeing the last week or last 4 weeks, and you can scroll through previous weeks. Beneath the summary is a table that shows the activity for each classroom. All of the data points we'll be looking at in this video will be found in this table. Now, let's walk through each of the stages. As you get started with Zearn, the first thing to look for in your data is that all teachers are signing in consistently. We recommend teachers sign into their Zearn school account at least once a week, if not more, to monitor students' pacing, identify any unproductive struggle, and celebrate students' successes. To see teacher sign-ins, let's go back to the classroom table in the School Goals Report. Look at the column labeled Last Teacher Sign-In to see which of your teachers have signed in recently and which may need support signing in to Zearn. If a teacher has not signed in recently, check in to make sure there isn't a problem with their sign-in credentials. The second thing to look for is that students are signing in regularly. Depending on how you're using Zearn, this is often daily or at least 3 times a week. In the School Goals Report, look at the percentage of active students. This tells you the percentage of students in each class that have signed into Zearn during the last week. If the last week was atypical, you can use the arrows to look at previous weeks. Assuming all students are using Zearn, you should expect this number to be close to 100% or similar to your attendance rate. Once teachers and students are signing in regularly, the next data point to look for is that students are learning on Zearn for at least 90 minutes a week. Our recent research shows that students who completed 3 or more grade-level lessons a week on Zearn, which contain built-in, just-in-time supports, experienced 2 to 3 times the growth of their peers. Each digital lesson usually takes about 30 minutes, which means students should get at least 90 minutes a week. In the School Goals Report, look at the average minutes per week. Classrooms where students are averaging 90 or more minutes a week are highlighted in green. If classrooms are not averaging 90 minutes a week, it may help to check in and pinpoint where Zearn fits in the daily schedule and explore how it works alongside live instruction. Once students are consistently averaging 90 minutes a week, that should give them enough time to reach the goal of completing 3 or more grade-level lessons a week. Again, completing 3 or more grade-level lessons a week, which include just-in-time supports, is where we see significant growth in student achievement. In the School Goals Report, look at the percentage completing 3+ lessons. This shows you the percentage of students in each class who completed at least 3 lessons that week. You can also see this reflected in the average lessons per week. Classes that average 3 or more lessons per week are colored in green. If students are working on Zearn for at least 90 minutes but aren't completing 3 or more lessons, teachers should check in with students to see where they might be struggling and taking more time. It's also important to know if the lessons students are completing are aligned to their grade level. We encourage teachers to begin students on grade level content, allowing the digital lessons to automatically launch just-in-time support as students need it. Of course, students' learning needs will vary, and assigning prior grade level lessons is sometimes helpful. With this in mind, the average on-grade lessons per week will show you the average number of grade level lessons each class completed that week. Comparing this to the average lessons per week will help you double check that the majority of the lessons students are completing align to grade level content. One final note on admin reports. If you ever want to see data from an individual classroom or student, you can always click on a class in the School Goals Report and select any of the class reports. Also, it's important to make sure all of your class rosters are correct before looking at your data. If your rostering process created duplicate or incorrect classes, you can correct this by editing them in the Roster tab or by contacting schoolaccounts@zearn.org. Finally, if you want to learn more about the other admin reports, which help you track completion across the school year and see individual student summaries, just go to the Reports tab and click the Admin Reports heading for summaries of each admin report. To summarize, you can use the School Goals Report to help your school move through each stage of implementing Zearn. First, ensure that all teachers and students are signing in to Zearn regularly. As classroom use grows more consistent, make sure students are learning on Zearn for at least 90 minutes each week. And finally, support your students in completing 3 or more grade level lessons each week. And that's it. You're ready to use the admin reports to support your teachers and students as they use Zearn. To learn more, join our hashtag MathFam by connecting with Zearn on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook for ongoing ideas and inspiration from teachers.